guys, it's 5 a.m. in D.C. I just finished packing.
My lash is done yesterday.
And I have my travel wig on. So we are ready for the December enjoyment. And I can't wait for you guys to see how lit we get in Ghana.
We are Africans, rooted with deep melanin. Growing up abroad, some of us heard the age-old remarks, go back to your country. Well, December in Ghana is the perfect time for that. Watch the cities flow in the city. Over the years, December in Ghana has taken over the travel blogs and social media tabloids. The season is like no other. With a vibrant event, it yields the perfect balance of rich history and the celebration of culture. Welcome to Accra, the land of enjoyment. I'll go kill you with enjoyment.
We're at the New Year's Eve PVO party and everybody's looking good.
They are beautiful girls, of course.
We're in the mood.
The bottles are coming in. We are ready for a good night.
We are the young, courageous entrepreneurs building our legacies for the next generation.
I am a lot of things.
Working at Amazon as a product marketing manager.
I can confidently say I've cooked for Prince Charles.
I'm currently a community partner manager at YouTube Shorts, so I'm currently taking a class in event planning.
Biggest break I had was Dancing Me, my song with Mr. Eugy, which completely changed my life.
Artist, songwriter, producer, performer, all-around lover boy, sugar daddy.
Even though we hustle hard, we play harder.
I wouldn't say I'm single. I'm single, but I'm not.
I don't think women miss when they shoot their shot. Men are not the ones with standards, ladies.
The ladies.
Sugar daddy.
Women will take, and not give.
Totally. We love, we laugh, we fight.
I thought this was gonna be a sensible conversation.
I thought I was working hard here too. Your hustle ain't even my hustle at all.
I am so shocked that she has brought up this video. Oh my God.
We cry. And that is because we are a family and responsible for each other. We are the true representation of the city life. No moto, no car, huh? Let's walk, let's talk. Go! Me, I know be trash, I know be baller. We overnight at the 10 baller. We 10 gun, now we chop proper. Now my papa is a talker. All my people, them go prosper. See, girl, when they hold posture. I done a whole lot. I done got a whole lot. You know, go find them, Nemo. Make your back carry cushion. All the places we go there. All the places that we go there. Break it down now, see Tobe. The way I like them, see body. All the places we go there. This money, it's making sense. I said, pretty mommy, go bring your friends.
My name is Amanda Foriwa Akosia Agyapong. I was born in Accra, Ghana, but I moved to the US when I was 7. And I went there for education, basically.
I'm currently a community partner manager at YouTube Shorts, but I also just started my own production company.
I love Amanda. Amanda's my homegirl. I met her because she went to Penn, I went to Princeton, and we just had a lot of mutual friends.
I met Amanda on my way to perform at Detty Rave, and she and her all of her sisters were catcalling me.
I'm Christabel. I'm 23 years old, just recently divorced. I'm joking. I'm not recently divorced.
So I'm currently taking a class in event planning. Ever since I was 16, I've loved weddings.
Christabel is my baby sister. I don't know how I'm kidding. I love Christabel.
So I met Christabel through Amanda, I would say. First thoughts, spicy personality, and I like it.
So we're pulling up to Rose Garden now because Christabel just landed and we wanted to have a family brunch
just to like chat about everything that's been going on. Our brother is there as well.
Cheers.
We haven't seen Kenneth in some months, so it's nice to get with him. He's our only big brother, so I guess we love him.
I am his favorite sister.
Exactly. He only calls Amanda on his own.
That's why I said time management, call your
sister. That's
sisters.
My guy.
Kennedy. No, I'm going to do better. Don't worry.
No,
I love you. I love you too,
don't
girl.
Worry.
Our dad's name is Kennedy Agyapong. He's a politician in Ghana, but also a great businessman.
A controversial politician at times, but you know, I would say that's where I get my energy and my personality from. I am one of 22 kids. I'm somewhere in the middle there.
I'm lucky number 7 of the 22. I can name all my siblings. It goes Shannon,
Kenneth,
Gifty, Nanadwa,
Anthonel,
Anel,
Amanda,
Christabel,
Tracy, Geraldine,
Abigail,
Yvonne,
Kelvin,
Kendrick,
Kendra,
Kwame, Kwisi,
Alexis,
Cassandra,
Ikya,
Nanekya.
Oh my God,
did I miss someone?
So there are 8 of us out of the 22 who are here at brunch today, and we're just here to kiki and see like what's going on in everyone's life, you know?
I'm celebrating graduating, getting a job.
I'm making a huge move across the country to Houston to bring myself out of my shell again.
This year, celebrating getting a new job.
Yes.
I'm also glad about starting the production company, Agyapong Productions.
So I wanted to start a production company because my sister and I were talking, and we were just going over like what are our passions, and if you had to choose one of your passions to start right now, what's it going to be?
This year I think it's been real good. Started working at the cold store now. The chicken is coming in. Literally, the chicken is coming in. But then also like Net2's picking up, Net2 among the friends picking up. Like work is good. Then we got approved to do Afrochella, so that's
yes.
That's definitely good.
Then in America?
No, Ghana. I'm talking about Ghana.
No, because it took so long.
Because it took so long to get approved because of COVID and whatnot, so it took us some time.
Listen, I am waiting till Afrochella day to even put my mouth on the door plate or not, according to last.
If I go Afrochella day and my name is on a table, Kenneth.
Done.
One thing I'm going to do is be at Afrochella. Like, I really think Afrochella is moving the culture in Ghana. It's been a tourism boom for sure, with people coming from all over the world.
This year, I'm thankful. I feel like sometimes I don't give myself enough credit. You called out the three savers over here, but I've also hit my savings goals for this year. I hit it 2 weeks ago. Okay, yes. So I'm proud of that. Daddy can already see my account, so.
How?
He has access to her.
Because he made my account. So sometimes he'll call me and be like, hey.
No.
My family is everything to me. Like, my sisters are literally my best friends.
My name is Dennis Nanakwikubwedi Jamina, popularly known as KiDi. I'm 28, although I tell people I'm 21 and they believe it. I grew up in Accra, I was born in Accra. My mom is Ghana, my dad is Kwo, so I'm half-half. I'm a dad of one, artist, songwriter, producer, songwriter again, performer, all-round lover boy, sugar daddy.
Nana and I were seeing the same girl in high school. I ended up getting the girl, even though he thinks otherwise. Great guy, good music.
It's so crazy to see, like, an artist that he is and how much he is willing to just drop that and be around the people he cares about the most. And he gonna take care of everybody in the room, honestly.
So I'm in the studio. I'm cooking, you know, making the next big worldwide hit. And I call up Barowski.
Yo, where are you there?
I'm doing some time. What's wrong?
Chale, I've been waiting for you for the past, 30 minutes? We for do that thing. Where are you there? I beg. Come listen to something I do.
What to do?
The next biggest global hit.
I met Barowski when I joined Lynx. You know, he was the... DJ for Lynx Entertainment. He used to play for Miss V. We became friends as the time went on.
Hey, Asau, what did they do?
What's good?
Listen.
Shut up.
Yeah, but listen to what I got, listen. If you don't like, give it to me straight. Okay.
I'm super excited about this song I'm writing because the lyrics are making sense. It's making too much sense. So when I put this song out there, every girl with a full pie is going to be like, oh, yes, KiDi sees me.
Okay, red flag, what's your biggest red flag?
Woo, guys, remember, I'm 5 months sober. And what I mean by that is I was love drunk for 2 years, and I'm 5 months sober. And lack of emotional intelligence is definitely a red flag.
Oh, my God. Oh, red flag, lack of reciprocity.
Yeah. Oh, wow. I really like that one. It sounds like a Ten Commandments.
We bring so much to the table that, you know, you just can't be eating all the food and then not putting anything in. Like, what are you cooking up, sir or her?
Do what you want done to you. Mm-hmm. Yes. Because if you want to run around chatting, have multiple people in your DMs, please never be upset when you look at my Instagram and it's the
allow
same.
Me to exactly.
We can do it harder. We can do it worse.
I actually don't have one. Because you guys are saying from experience.
I personally haven't experienced any red flags because I haven't really dated. I just recently started dating seriously. So when my sisters are like going around saying the red flags, I'm just here to listen.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Abby. Happy birthday to you.
Hello, KiDi. You want to finish me? Finish me with your beauty. It be your fupa and your walkings. Make me want to give my heart to you.
You get heart to the gift.
You like him?
You get heart to the gift.
Yeah. Yeah, he knows.
Well, you know what I mean? I have too much heart to give.
The course, you sound like you stole from somewhere.
I don't know. Anyway, like the focus is, you know, fupa girls don't get a lot of love. If a girl with fupas and, you know, like this is a song to, you know,
I like
them
know
that
like
we appreciate them.
I'll be a goofy take them.
For what? It's mine.
Your album makes food.
Every time I write a song, he listens to it and tells me whether it's good or not. And he likes the song, so I know it's going to be good. Watch out. Women with a fupa, I'm coming for you guys, man. Boom. I'm in the spirit. Yeah, we are looking for the next
one. Because this one, it go blow past. Touch it. What do you think?
Oh, I touch it. It go. O2 is also coming. Yeah. And we're preparing for it. Like, we're ready for it.
We were spoiled. I mean, like, I always talk. It's always like
Ghana boys bringing the heats.
Yeah.
That's it.
The thing be like right now with the start. It's like we're just starting. I mean, that's something I always say because, Charlie, even though we feel we catch it there, somebody else do something better. So, I mean.
And you know what's crazy? I feel like in a few years, right, everything we do now, mm-hmm. it will be so irrelevant.
Of course.
Because when would they, like in 5, 10 years, when KiDi is on stage performing, I go view J Touch itself from the list inside because Touch itself no reach. That's the goal.
Because we're going to get there. I mean, we talk.
Inshallah.
Yeah.
I mean, thanks for coming. As you tell me, say the song hits, I go question you.
I mean,
you be the DJ of the year, so yes, you get the ESA.
If I touch him like this,
Allah, Osafu Moku.
So every time I make a song, I want to hear the DJ perspective from him, what he thinks, because he plays a lot of gigs. And he knows the songs and when they drop. So I love that opinion from him a lot, and I respect his opinion on most of the songs I write. Yeah.
My name is Wilglory Tanjong, and I am a lot of things. I am an entrepreneur. I am a student. Being in an MBA program is my side hustle. My full-time hustle is Anima Arts.
I met Wilglory via email. I had sent an email to her when I was a sophomore in college to ask about a Facebook internship she had done. She left me on read. And then we ended up following each other on Instagram, and we've just been friends ever since.
I'm actually Cameroonian. I was born in Cameroon, but I do love coming to Ghana. I'm here with Nannette to meet up with her for the first time. I actually haven't seen her ever since I got to Ghana. I'm really, really excited.
My name is Nannette. I am 23 years old. I was born in Atlanta, Georgia, but I moved to Ghana when I was 5 and I was raised here. Went to boarding school in the States, Columbia in New York, and then now I'm living in DC, working at Amazon as a product marketing manager.
I met Nannette through Amanda. She is an amazing kind of person. Always smiling, always bubbly, always bringing the energy. The girl likes to dance.
How have you been?
I'm good, girl. There's just like so much to do. I feel like I'm always working.
I see that on Instagram all the time.
All the time. Yeah. Like, I feel like even though I've stopped working for December, like I still have the pop-up to do here.
Right,
and I have like our photo shoot to do as well for our spring-summer collection.
Okay, nice.
I am hanging with my girl, Wilglory. We're just catching up. We haven't seen each other in person since I think our Mexico trip, which was like almost a year ago.
So much has changed. Remember we were like posted up in the apartment, I was taking like product shots? Like,
girl, you were working during the entire trip.
It was absolutely crazy. And then of course, Beyonce.
The celebrity of all celebrities. Wore my bag, child. No one can tell me nothing. The celebrities of all celebrities wore my bag. She loved it. She even altered it to wear it around her waist. That's how I know she really wanted to wear it.
It was honestly the most humbling experience because it came out of nowhere. Like, a lot of people are like, oh, did you know that she was gonna wear your bag? And I'm like, no, Beyonce did not message me like, hey girl, I'm about to change your life.
About to wear your bag.
The first image that popped up on my Instagram feed was Beyonce.
There are so many wins that God has blessed me with. My God, I mean, it has just been incredible.
I grew up in a small village in Ghana in the eastern region. Growing up, we used to always, and this is part of like my story of just going into food or just starting a business in food. We used to always eat around the table together as a family. The first business I started was called Bishville, which graduated into a boutique catering business. And then I have the private chef company, which that offers private chef services to high-end clients. NDAs will restrict me from saying a lot of people I've cooked for, but I can confidently say I've cooked for Prince Charles, Naomi Campbell, Jack Dorsey, the presidency, and very important families in Ghana.
Kwame and I kiki all the time. Together, we just bounce off each other so much that we end up fighting. Ooh, that man can get on my nerves.
Kwame is like that itch when a mosquito bites you and just keeps scratching and you're like, oh my God, go away. You know what I'm saying? But then like the itch is like kind of satisfying.
No, my uncle was making fun of me. He was like, if you ever got in a relationship, like, just off rip is gonna be a long distance relationship because you are always away.
I hope you've accepted that though. Like,
it's real. Love him.
Okay.
Yep.
Yeah.
No,
like,
that's real. I mean, it just
hopefully you like to travel too, though.
Girl, I'm so motherfucking single, dog. Like,
I'm definitely very single. Almost too single, in my opinion. I'm starting to get worried. I worked too hard. That's why I'm like, damn. So before I came to Ghana, I was like, damn, I'm hella single. Like, I don't even got nobody I'm texting. Whew.
But what about you, girl? What do you have going on?
I don't know if it's the Gemini in me. I don't know what it is. I feel like I'm always restless, like looking for the next thing. So last year I like started playing with one of my ideas. It was an African language school. I feel like a lot of people around me are constantly trying to learn their local language. They want to connect with their families. They want to understand the music they're listening to.
I just started wondering during COVID lockdown, if you wanted to learn your local language, an African local language, how would you do it?
So I actually started very, very, let's call it a soft launch last year, where I was just offering tree classes.
Okay.
And so I hired like two teachers from Ghana, and I was just promoting on Clubhouse. I just put up a website, which I'm planning to launch as well at the beginning of next year.
This is fire. the thing is, I have like so much going on.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like I have Anima Iris, then I have like my personal life and my friends and my family, and then I have like school with Wharton as well.
Ooh.
And I will admit though, I think like earlier, throughout the year, I've been working so much that I really did abandon my mental health, right? Mm. And that honestly led to me having like a full-fledged breakdown when school like restarted. And so for the longest time, I have been like, you know, not doing, getting back into therapy again. Mm. And so I just restarted it.
I think it's so interesting hearing her say that, you know, she started going to therapy again, and that's like such a big part of her like finding balance, because for me that's something I've always wanted to do. I just haven't found the time.
So I'm in the car and I'm just writing down like some of my New Year's resolutions. I'm on my way to Pinkberry to meet with Christabel and my assistant Kev. We have to go over a bunch of stuff for the show, like our upcoming production schedule.
Hello.
Amanda.
Who gave you this number? Who gave you my number? Who is this?
I get a call from Eugy inviting me to his welcome party that's going to be at Luna.
Yes, what's up?
I'm having a party.
You're having a party and you need me there. You need me there.
I actually met Eugy backstage of Detty Rave. He came up to me to ask me my name. I don't know why. And from there, like, we became fast friends. I look at Eugy like an older brother because he's so much older than me.
Okay, I'll get the girls together.
We're going to be starting with Eugy's welcome party, but after that, like, everything else kicks off. I just got to Pinkberry. We have a ton to go over for the show, but at the same time, like, I don't want to do it in a boring office, so we decided to come to Pinkberry because I love a treat.
How's it been on the ground so far? What did I miss? Get me up to date.
We need to officially register Agyapong Productions under Cadigan.
Mm-hmm.
We need to go over accounting tomorrow.
For sure.
Mm-hmm. We'll be doing run-up shows with next week. And okay, then cool. Anything else is like the Afrocella fitting.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, I was actually talking to Eugy today and he invited us to his party. He said to invite the rest of the girls. You spoken to Nana?
I haven't. Yeah, I mean, I told him that I landed, but.
no chats.
I mean, listen, anytime I see them together, it's giving vibes. But they knew that already, you know?
But besides that, did you think how Kevin's matching me today?
Right.
Looking real cute. It's looking real cute.
My little hat is cute.
Yes, it wasn't on purpose.
I love the synergy though.
Right.
Let's keep that going.
Mm-hmm. Kev is Amanda's executive assistant. He's great. Don't we look cute together? I thought so too.
So
next week is our packed week, and then after that, early January is looking good for us.
Yeah. I'm feeling really stressed, overwhelmed, but I'm excited at the same time because I feel like it's gonna be good.
Yeah.
I'm tired already. Like,
ready
to start. I'm tired.
I'm exhausted.
But you wanna go out tonight?
I wanna go out tonight.
Yeah.
We have to be outside for sure.
Yeah.
We came to work, but enjoyment.
It's a part of the work.
Enjoyment. I was gonna say, Kev.
Uh-huh.
Do you know when Christopher and I were younger, we would literally call each other on the phone because we lived in two separate houses. We'd call each other on the phone and just discuss all the things we were gonna do when we saw each other.
No, like we would
plan our lives. A schedule. We'd be like, we're gonna play American Idol and everyone's gonna sing, and then we'll do tiger and floor tennis.
Yes. And like we planned the high schools we wanted to go to together.
Yes.
We came up with like a whole. I'll be a cheerleader. She's a hip hop dancer.
Oh my gosh.
Like,
we would be like, our boyfriends have to kiss us by the locker.
Like, we were planning. No.
Amanda and I do a lot of things together.
I get asked all the time, like, you have 10 billion siblings. How did you choose one to work on this project with? I literally ran to her room. Like, I ran to her room and I said, I have this idea. And she said she likes to interview people. So I'm like, well, you're on board.
One thing we're gonna do is plan.
Okay.
Right. Yeah, we are.
And that's why this has gone so well.
That's my girl. That was real aggressive.
Damn.
My brother Eugy reached out to me for his own party in Ghana because he had never had his own thing. So obviously, because I have the venue, we decided to do at Luna.
So I have a performance coming in a couple of hours out of town, but the driver isn't ready. So I'm trying to, you know, see what Kwame is up to at Luna since we're preparing for Eugy's party.
I
was like, I have to leave Accra like 10. So I have a few more hours before I left.
We're just in the group class.
What did you like then now? Shall I give you one shisha?
Yeah, then they bring up.
Everybody did.
We don't start it.
The calm before the storm.
But Charlie, right now, the yawa be say, you do go look for Ivory Coast.
Ooh. You did joke.
You flight delay. Eugy didn't show up for sound check. So I messaged my brother, like, Eugy, what's up?
Of course, Charlie. Tonight, the enjoyment must continue.
Hey, Charlie.
Where am I now? Where am I now?
Amanda, I'm waiting for Christabel and Brianna.
Why them already come?
So Amanda has been trying to hook me up with this girl. I've seen a few pictures of her. I've seen her Instagram. It's nice.
All right. All the girls are on their way, by the way.
Who is coming?
You know the girls, like, who's in town. Christabel, of course. Anthony, Geraldine, Brianna.
I was very excited when Amanda said Brianna was going to be at Luna at the welcome party. And Brianna was actually on her way. So she's on her way now, coming. it's going to be an interesting night.
Justina. Brianna.
Justina is my friend. We had a little bit of an issue when she was in Ghana in summer.
Justina's coming. Why didn't I tell you Justina's coming?
Yeah.
Why would I have to tell you Justina's coming?
I'm going to make it so awkward today.
What do you mean I'm about to make it awkward? That's what I'm saying.
We are friends, no?
Are you? When she
yes,
gets here,
are you?
When she gets here, ask her if you guys are friends.
Oh, so she's not going to talk to me?
What do you mean?
Is she mad at me?
Dang.
Nannette.
My friend.
Oh, hello.
Hi there.
Hey, girl.
Oh, thank you so much.
Hi.
This is
Hi.
Nannette.
We have nice not met. You. Hello, I'm Nannette.
You look nice.
Thank you,
Purple
you too.
Purple rain.
Right. Thank you.
Hey, girl.
Hi, Amanda.
Hello.
Hi.
Come on in. Go ahead.
Okay. Thank you.
Actually, need to
go. Yeah, come close. Come close.
Hey. Like, I don't know if he wants like personal space.
Oh no, I don't need my space for anything.
Wow.
Use my space.
Okay.
Use my space.
Is this good?
It's good. Close you're even not close enough.
Like, you guys should be
body to body, you know. Nannette walks in, and I was like, ooh la la. That's a Ghanaian babe. You know, so, but I might be mistaken, but if I'm right, there's some, you know, little flirty things going on.
I think we're gonna have a good friendship going forward just based on our first interaction.
We'll be right back.
my God. One thing Kwame is going to do is date an Amanda's friend. Like, it's every day one of my friends lands. That's what he likes to do. Who's that? Yeah. Today, I'm even scared because one from the past is here, one from the present is here, and he has eyes on both. It's given, he doesn't know where he wants his eyes to go.
Before we all got there, he kept going on and on about Brianna. Brianna, 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 Brianna. I'm like, Kwame, shut up! Then Brianna walks in, yeah. She's an long thing. It's like Kwame at that point wishes he was cross-eyed, you know, because one eye is on just the other eyes and like, a bad boy.
Amanda has very interesting friends and very nice friends. Amanda is always exaggerating. I've been on a date with maybe two of her friends, but she thinks I've done, you know, 100.
This became so from town. I got a girl, she a London thing. She wanna roll one, smoke one thing. I'm on to give her a diamond ring. But she say other girls like my thing. She make my heart beat yeah. Like so boom boom. Next time you're gonna take you to Bloom Bloom. When we done, we go go home and boom boom. Hop on the wagon, baby say vroom vroom. Say cheese, take a picture. Shag a post, make a see, take a picture. Say cheese, take a picture. Shag a post, make a see, take a picture. Say cheese.
I'm looking around. Eugy is nowhere to be found.
Where is Eugy?
No moto, no car, huh? Let's walk, let's talk. Go! Me, I know be trash, I know be baller. Way overnight at the 10 baller. We thank God, now we chop proper. Now my papa inside talker. All my people, them go prosper. See girl with the hood posture. I done a whole lot. I done got a whole lot. See way, see big go be. You know go find that me more way. Make your back a ricochet. All the places we go there. All the places that we go there. Break it down now, see tobe. The way I like them, see body. All the places we go there. This money, it's making sense.